Introduction to Geometry, Level 5. In this video, we're going to go over basic examples that ask us to find the intersection and union of various geometric figures. Before we jump into some examples, let's refresh our memory and talk about sets. Say I have two distinct sets. Let's call them set A and set B. Recall that a set is a collection of objects. These objects are referred to as the elements of the set. In this example, the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 are the elements of set A. Likewise, the numbers 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, and 12 are the elements of set B. When dealing with sets, we are often asked to find the union or intersection between two or more sets. If we are asked to find the union between set A and B, we would denote it as follows. A union B. This symbol is pretty easy to remember, since it resembles the letter U for union. In essence, the union between two sets consists of all the elements in A or in B or in both. You can think of a union as the process of merging the elements of both sets together. In this example, A union B will be equal to a new set that contains every element that is in either set A or set B, including those elements that are common to both set A and B. In contrast, if we are asked to find the intersection between set A and B, we would denote it as follows. A intersection B. This symbol looks like an upside-down U, and it sort of looks like the capital letter A if you use your imagination. Imagining the capital letter A will remind you of the word AND, since the intersection of two sets creates a new set containing the elements in both A and B. In this example, A intersected B would equal to the set containing the elements 2, 4, and 6, since these elements are in both A and B. Graphically, you can see the reason why this is called the intersection between two sets. It's literally an intersection or overlapping of common elements. The final concept we need to be familiar with is the idea of an empty set. Let's take set A and set B and remove the elements common to both sets. Now, if we were asked to find A intersection B, we would see that there are no common elements between set A and B. In this case, we would obtain what is referred to as an empty set, and we use this symbol to denote the empty set. An empty set is special in the sense that it contains no elements. Alright, now that we are refreshed and familiar with the concepts associated with sets, let's go ahead and try the first example. Use the following figure to answer the following questions. How many lines are shown? Name these lines. By looking at the figure, we can see that there are two distinct lines. So the answer to the first question is 2. Now, the second question is asking us to name them. Let's focus on the line that contains points D, B, and E. This line can be named by using two points, so we can name this line as line DE or line DB or line BD or line BE or line EB or line ED. Notice that this line is labeled with the lowercase letter M. So we can also name this line as line M. In the same manner, the line that contains points A, B, and C can be named as line AB or line AC or line BA or line BC or line CB or line CA. Remember, lines can be named by denoting two points located on the line or by using a lowercase letter whenever possible. Alright, let's try the second example. Where do line AC and line DE intersect? Using set notation, this problem translates to the following expression. Line AC intersection line DE. Looking at the lines, we see that they intersect at a common point, in this case, point B. So line AC intersection line DE is equal to point B. Let's try the next example. Where does ray AC intersect line BC? Using set notation, this problem translates to the following expression. Recall that you can think of a ray as being the set of all points that starts at one endpoint in this case point A, and goes in the direction of another point, in this case point C. In the same manner, a line is a set of all points that extends infinitely in both directions. So the following points are located on line BC. For this problem, we are looking for the points that both ray AC and line BC have in common, hence the intersection. In this case, the common points start intersecting at point A and extend infinitely in the direction of point C. Therefore, the intersection of ray AC and line BC is equal to ray AC. Alright, let's try the next example. What is the union of ray BA and ray BD? Using set notation, this problem translates to the following expression. First, let's locate each of the rays. Ray BA is located here, and ray BD is located here. You can think of the union as a merger between these two rays. We want to include all the points on ray BA or BD, or in both. Recall that an angle is formed when two rays have a common point of intersection, called the vertex. This is essentially what happens when we form the union of these two rays. Therefore, the union of ray BA and ray BD is equal to angle ABD or angle DBA. Alright, let's move along to the next example. Find the intersection of ray AB with ray CA. Using set notation, this problem translates to the following expression. Once again, let's identify the set of all points located on ray AB. Then we need to identify the set of all points on ray CA. Now it's just a matter of finding where the set of points of these two rays intersect. We see that the set of points on both rays start intersecting at point A and end at point C. In essence, the set of points intersect along a common line segment, in this case, line segment AC. So the intersection of these two rays is equal to line segment AC. Alright, let's end the video with the final example. Find the intersection of triangle ABC and ray DE. Using set notation, this problem translates to the following expression. The set of all points located on triangle ABC are represented as follows. And the set of all points located on ray DE are represented as follows. For this problem, we are looking for the intersection of these two set of points. Notice that both sets intersect at a common point. In this case, they intersect at point F. So the intersection of triangle ABC and ray DE is a set containing point F. Alright, in our next video, we will continue covering slightly more challenging examples involving the union and intersection of geometric figures.